charge.
There's a, we have a matriarch. We have a woman in charge. I'm all about the feminine.
Doesn't your friend owns the property or?
Yeah, my friend. Well, a friend of ours owns the property. Yes, and I mean, like, we don't have any taxes or anything. We don't have any, you know, worries about that. There's no payment. You know, I mean, it's owned. It's outright owned. There's no bank. There's nothing involved. And so, you know, like, they'll just do what we have been doing without me. They'll grow their food, you know, try to live in Ogdeo, live harmoniously, invite people to come. More people. Now there's six. Now there's probably five because my apprentice probably left when I did, you know.
Where'd he go?
He got a job offer in L.A. to teach skills to elementary kids' schools, you know, kids. And if I'm not around to be there, I'm sure he went and, you know, taught for a while. And then when I come back, I imagine he'll come back again.
So you don't have a cell phone? You have a house phone?
No. Mike, one of our members, has a smartphone. And so if I need to use a call or somebody needs to get a hold of me, they just call Mike and then he tells me to call him back. And we all split the bill, you know. Our money works like this. If we have money, we give it to Tracy. She's in charge of the place, right? The matriarch. And she pays all the bills. And if we need money, I say, hey, Tracy, I want to buy some hot dogs. Can I have $5? She says, sure. That way, I don't frivolously spend money like I would normally. I have to actually ask for some. Because otherwise, I'd be like, oh, yeah, we're going to Wendy's. You know what I mean?
I'm getting some beer on the way home.
Yeah, exactly. But I kind of like having to ask because it makes me really think about things before I just buy them, you know?
It's smart.
Yeah. But you got to trust the person who's in charge, you know, because she could be like, going down to the casino, you know what I mean? But she's really
usually
great.
Women are less frivolous. I mean,
more frugal.
I mean, yeah. We just spend money on whatever. I do that at home.
Oh,
like,
dude.
I'm like, I want this and
Harbor
this.
Freight's having a sale. Let's stop and see what they got.
Yeah.
You know, and, oh my God. So anyway, she's really great.
I mean, how does it work there? Like, there's couples there, there's single people.
There's couples and single people. Whoever wants to come is welcome as long as they want to be there. And if they want to be there, that means that they take an interest in what we're doing, you know? Like, I don't want to have to ask you to do the dishes. If you're happy being somewhere and you see some dishes, you do it. It's only if you're like, I don't really like being here and I don't want to contribute, that you don't help out around.
Right.
Does that make sense? Like, I do the dishes almost every day at lunch because I want there to be harmony here. You know what I mean? And I don't mind. I'm not bitching about it, but I want to live with people who want to take care of me too. I take care of you. You take care of me.
I don't know why more people aren't all out here working with you.
It doesn't matter. Why they're not out here is a value system thing, right? You can get 2 pounds of carrots for a dollar. You know what I mean?
Right.
Financially, growing a garden is not
an
economical idea, right? And I can't argue with that at all. I don't grow food to sell a market. Are you kidding me?
What else are you going to do? It's something to do.
Dude!
Keep you busy.
Dude! More than that. There's only one thing here that can get everybody some exercise and get everybody doing it together.
Oh.
You don't need 15 people on your work crew. We got 4 hammers.
I know.
Right? We only got, how much are we going to build?
Right.
They don't need 15 people milking cows.
I know.
They've got 2 cows. We could have 2, maybe 4 people working. We could all work together in the garden every day for 4 hours and have fun and sing. And people are bored here. They're twiddling their thumbs. They're not sleeping good because they didn't get any exercise. You need to work. You need to do something.
You know what we're talking about and I talked to Chris about today? We're really going to push for the plastic for the greenhouse.
Great.
Okay.
Great. I mean, I'd rather have the damn fencing. I mean, but I've been promised that, you know.
You need to stay on that. Stay, you know.
Well, you know what I want to push for?
You need to go bug them.
I want to make the house more homey. Everybody here is living out of their box. It's like they're just camping waiting for the year to pass. We need a home here. We need people to be comfortable here. I want to push for making some bookshelves, for making a hangout nook somewhere. Like, I wish Bella, would make like, somebody could sit on Bella's bench, somebody could sit on Kristen's bench, and then you can have like a little cozy nook corner to talk in. You know what I mean? Like, already there's people sitting on Kristen's bed with her, talking with her. It's comfortable. It's cozy. What do we have to do to make some couches? What do we have to do to, like, get people feeling like this is home? This isn't just a camping thing. This isn't just I'm barely making it.
Well, people are making some furniture, and I think the next step is beds. You know, that's the only reason I was worried that you made the 2.
Mm-hmm.
It's just now everybody's like, well, It's that the haves and the have-nots, you know what I mean?
Man, nobody said a word about it to me.
That's the only reason I said something.
Yeah.
Because I just don't want people to, because.
Well, let's make more. We got.
Let's just get some money and make more.
Let's get this place cozy. Let's keep people sleeping at night because people that sleep good interact way better. Mm-hmm. People that are at home, what we can't have is people thinking there's just 10 more months left and then I can go home. There's just 9 more months left.
Right.
That means they're not here. That means they're not trying, right? I want them to be comfortable here. I want them to be happy here. And to do that, they need food and they need a nice place to sleep.
I just don't feel like we have the right people here.
I'm with you.
We don't have the right people here.
I am confident that every month we're going to get people that want to be here, that aren't just here for ego. Every month we're going to drop one that's hard to handle, and we're going to get one that's more positive. I am very confident. If I didn't think that, I wouldn't be here. Right?
Yeah.
And even if I didn't think that, I want to believe that. We'll know in a week's time what we get.
Well, I have hope. Good. I wouldn't be here.
I have hope, too.
I have hope, yep. You know?
I have hope, too.
That's why I get up. I try and get something done. If I wasn't building the stuff I'm doing, I'll come help you.
Come help me. I love your company. I don't care about what we get done. I want to be with people.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy. I know that this is a futile effort, right? Sure, we'll get some crops and stuff, but nothing that we can make way more money and buy more food. I want to work with people.
Yeah. This is something we can all do together as a community.
Demand people do it. Mm-hmm. I gotta have fun over there, make things beautiful. People see things moving, they'll want to join in. I'm dealing with that whole drama from before. People see the garden and they're like, you know what I mean? But you're right. We need to we'll ditch some people every month. We'll get rid of a hard one and we'll get a better one. You watch.
I know. I'm hoping. Yep. Unfortunately, I think it's gonna be Bella.
I think it's unfortunate as well because I'd much rather get rid of the other one.
Oh.
Same time, I'm worried about Bella. I told you. Mm-hmm. I told her to her face. I might very well vote for you because I'm scared for your physical and mental health.
Yeah.
And that's more important to me than what we can do here. People are thinking about her losing her marbles. You know what I mean? Like, at nighttime, it's dangerous. I'm worried about her.
I know.
I don't want her to lose her marbles. I did talk to her about something, though. I don't know if I told you. I said to her, you're going to get voted out anyway. There's 9-6, and I might vote with you anyway. You're out. Can you leave on your own? You can come and stay at my farm for 2 months. We'll take care of you. You know, if you need some money, I'll be willing to work with you on that, too. Then we can get Aaron out. If you pull one for the team, you leave 2 days early. It's just 2 days. On your own, they'll inject somebody, and we can choose.
No, but she doesn't. Then she won't. That breaks her contract, too.
Yeah, so you break your contract, what do you do? They don't pay you. Right. No problem. I can offer her something way better than that, a place to stay for free. And if she needs the money, I'll give her the money myself.
Yeah.
$1,000 a month till it's paid off.
Wow.
I don't care about the money. I'm not here for money.
Right.
I'm here because I want to do something different.
Right, same.
If she makes it to the last minute, she submarines us who have to be here and stay longer. We need help to get rid of Aaron. What did she say? She said, to the bitter end.
Really?
Oh, yeah, she ain't leaving or nothing.
Yeah.
But she'll think about it. And I can only hope.
Yeah. You know? Well, I'm hoping that maybe ever.
If she's losing her marbles, dude. Dude. I will vote for her if I'm scared for her sanity. I will. I don't care about the politics.
Is that parsley right there?
No, it's carrots.
Oh, God, they're ready to go.
Well, Chris just thinned, but it was the middle of the day, and so he gave me all his thin ones. They yanked up, and they've been in the direct sunlight. And so I just planted them all. I should have planted them in the ground, but it was the middle of the day. I can't plant them in the ground, right? They'll just die of harshness.
They'll be okay. Did you water them?
I did, of course. I transplanted them all in there. Carrots are do not like being transplanted.
No.
Do not.
No.
He just wouldn't wait. I said, do it at night. Do it first thing in the morning. I get 50% success,
I've got him. He came by to help me work on my boxes. And then he keeps asking me. So I finally was like, and he's the only one that showed interest.
Good. I like him.
I asked Rob, hey, do you want to help? He's like, nah.
I'm glad he came by. He likes building.
No, I know. And but you know, he's doing stuff. He's hitting stuff and doing little. And I'm just like,
I know. He's just.
But But you know what? He'll do it, and you know.
He's also know-it-all. You know, like he's trying to pull a nail out of a board the other day, you know, and the nail's sticking up that tall. Yeah. He's blowing, blowing. And so I go and I grab a 2x4 and I just like put it underneath, you know, it changes the angle.
Yeah.
Right?
You put just the, twist it.
Yeah. Yeah, you put the 2x4 under and then your hammer is. Right. Well, he was pretty grumpy about it. You know what I mean? Because it was like, I've embarrassed him in front of Hex. You know, like he's seeing a teacher out of carpenter. And like the most basic things like levers with hammers and pulling nails and stuff, he doesn't know.
Yeah.
So it's just dangerous to deal with people who don't know but think they know.
Right.
So that makes me nervous. And I'm with you. If they're ignorant and they admit they don't know, I'm happy to teach them. But when they're ignorant and they think they know, it makes me impatient. But here, you just gotta suck it up, dude. You know?
Yeah. One thing I'm worried about losing Bella also is she brings in some money.
I don't care about that. Things. We make so much money here, dude. Money's just gonna come in more.
I know, but she's really doing well right now.
You know, you say that, but I think when people see her, 9 out of 10 people here are like this. You know what I mean? They're like, there's too much trauma, there's too much wounding, there's too much pain that she's already caused here.
Yeah.
And if we lose her, I'd love to get rid of Aaron, please. Understand that, it's my priority.
No.
But losing her frees up a lot of people's hatred.
Right.
And I'm not saying it's right, but I see that as being a benefit to us. And as far as I'm concerned, she made her bed in this regard.
She did.
You know what I mean?
She did.
I have nothing against her personally. You know I've got a ton of energy into supporting her. We worked in the garden for 2 hours a day because I wanted to give her some energy. I like Bella. But at the same time, there's history here that people can't let go of. And right. If we're going to start fresh.
That's right. And people can't like see a new day as a new opportunity.
That's what I'm saying.
It always carries over day to day, right?
Some people can, but right. Not everybody here. A lot of immature people here. Mm. And I want to have a fresh start. If we can get rid of those two, just not because of the old trauma is all. And because I'm worried about her sanity.
Well, I'm worried about her.
I didn't ask you.
No, I know that. Yeah. I'm just saying, because I care about her, you know? And she. All right.
What are we starting?
Meeting.
Okay.
Our government meeting. But I'm gonna. I really think that America's gonna go for Aaron, and I'm definitely gonna vote for him, mm-hmm. Just so he knows, like, I'm coming after him.
I understand. It depends on how things are going with the other one. If I'm worried about her.
No, I know that. But even if I think probably Nikki will, probably Amanda will. I don't
go
know.
For Aaron.
Yeah.
Let's see how the week with cooking goes, because if he steps down gracefully and stuff, if he's willing to show some change, you know?
We're all interested to see what he's going to do during this week.
That'll determine everything.
Yes.
There's no argument.
If the cooking goes well and he just works out and doesn't do anything, yep. Like...
He said he's going to work in the garden, but he's promised me multiple times he's going to come work in the garden. He never has even once, except for when he was forced to.
Yeah. I remember him saying that, but it'll be interesting to see what he does, and I think a lot of people are watching that. Chris actually brought that up.
Mm-hmm.
We're all kind of paying to do, and then we need you.
That's right.
Right?
Yep. A man can hope.
Yep.